Welcome back to another segment of Behind the Scenes of the Waltons. Today, I have a very special guest. I am being joined by actor David Doremus, who played G.W. Haines, originally Mary Ellen's boyfriend. And then in later seasons, he was Aaron's boyfriend. When you have somebody great, you want to try and keep him in the family. Anyway, I was so thrilled to be able to reconnect with David and to have him come join me here and talk about his time on the Waltons and life and other things in his career. So please welcome David Doremus. Well, here we are. Yay.
All this time.
Yeah. We made it.
Are you done?
I am well, thank you. How are you?
Very good. Very good. Family's good. All well. Can't complain.
Good.
Yeah. So what kind of questions? What things do you want to know?
Let's go back to the beginning. We'll start with the Waltons and then I'll backtrack a bit. So Your initial introduction was in actually the first episode we filmed, although it was about the fifth to air, which was The Hunt.
Correct. Where
we introduce you as Mary Ellen's sort of, you know, wannabe. She wants you as her boyfriend, and there's the wonderful love triangle between my rival Martha Rose Coverdale.
Oh yeah, she was quite the special girl, I tell you. She almost wanted to make you hate her. I mean, she had that kind of character. And, you know, you were so nice and really just wanting to talk to GW, to be with him and stuff like that. She's like, you will do this, you will do that. You know, it's like
but she was, you know, she was really pretty and girls were limited in Walton's Mountain. So I could understand the attraction. And I mean, you were so good at playing humor, you know, some of the, and looking just sort of a little clueless, you know, which was so brilliant and so made it work. You could kind of, you know, it was such a wonderful character that you created there in the way you played GW. You know?
Well, thank you. Yeah. I mean, I enjoyed it, but it's interesting because I have gone back and seen, you know, reviewed some of the shows and stuff, and I can definitely tell my immaturity with regards to acting, even though I had a series previously. And, you know, and then I saw it develop even towards the end. So that was enjoyable. It was fun for me to see that, you know, here at an older age, long after. I didn't see that when I was younger, but I definitely see that now. So
oh, I totally know what you mean. I can watch episodes and there's some scenes that I'm like, oh, love that. And then I'll see another scene and go, okay, that's a little weak on my part. You know, I'm good at these kinds of scenes. I struggle a bit more with these kinds of scenes. You know?
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
And I think, I just had a couple interviews for the Waltons. I think Earl already knew who I was, but obviously, you know, meeting and doing dialogue with you and the mesh, I mean, apparently they saw how you and I worked together. So that's what ended up making it. So I don't know how many people you actually, you know, interviewed with or so on for the part of GW, but
I don't remember reading with anyone else. So I think it might have been a callback situation that they brought me in to read with you, maybe just for a final kind of what was that like. But I remember over the course of the 9 seasons, twice when they brought me in to read with somebody. And oddly, it was never, I mean, with you, you were a character that was going to recur and did. But they didn't bring me in to read with Tom Bauer, who played my husband.
Oh my
they
gosh.
Didn't bring me in to read with David Spencer, who, you know, Bob Woods, who played my fiance. So I mean, it was interesting. I think a lot of it was just timing and stuff, you know, to get us away from set or things like that was probably tricky.
Yeah, interesting. Yeah. I didn't know how that worked out, but you know, of course, couple years ago, I hardly even remember, you know, I hardly remembered interviewing. I mean, I think it was twice, but it might've been just the one time with you. So, I don't recall, to tell you the truth, except for, of course, our, you know, us getting together and talking and doing dialogue. So, yeah, it was fun. At that point in time, I was actually getting phone calls where my agent would say, show up on set tomorrow at 8 o'clock. And it's like, well, for what? I didn't interview for anything. They said, don't worry about it. Be there at 7 for makeup. They'll give you your script and you'll start at 8. And it's like, okay. So I did have that, you know, that appearance, I guess, or people knew who I was in the industry. So that was kind of fun, but kind of nerve-wracking as well, because you're there learning your lines and everything at a moment's notice and then going on set. So It was, so obviously the Waltons, again, Earl knew myself. Earl knew Ellen Corby previously, because I had actually been reviewing some Nanny the Professor. And there was one that I believe the name of the show was The Treehouse, to where we were trying to save a neighborhood, you know, big giant oak or something like that. And I noticed that Ellen Corby had actually had, she was one of the picketers.
Ah.
And of course, not knowing at the time who she was, but later, you know, being on the Waltons, you look at that and go, oh my gosh, that's Grandma Walton. Wow, she was, I knew her before, you know. And I don't recall her ever mentioning that to me, that she obviously knew me from previous. So very curious as how it all works out at times when you just don't know who's going to be on what set, when and where, how, and so on. So,
yeah. And, you know, when you do a series, there were so many people who came through our show. And in some cases, they later went on to a really successful career. But this was early, like someone like a Sissy's Basic, or, you know, Ron Howard was already, you know, had already done, you know, his Andy Griffith, and was right before he did Happy Days and stuff. So you remember working with people like that. But there was all kinds of other people that did a lot of work. But I will look back at an episode and go, oh, that's so-and-so. But at the time, I didn't know. And maybe I didn't even have scenes with them.
Yeah.
So I don't remember.
That's one of the really difficult things, is because, as you know, and I know, going on to a set, filming your specific, you know, scenes, and not being involved in any of the rest of the show, it's like, what really happened? And unless you really read through the whole script, which I know myself, I a lot of times did not. You know, I read the scenes I was in, I memorized the lines previous to mine and my lines, and that's about it, you know. And I went back to school playing football, or, you know, whatever, and, you know, going snow skiing and not really watching or getting the whole drift of how I was involved in that particular script. So it was different. But so again, you just don't know who really, I mean, well, I was watching one of the shows I was on, and I just had a little tidbit. I was just there for just a little bit. So it's like, was I in that episode? I don't think I remember that. And, you know, you review it and go, oh my, that's right, I was in that scene of the whole, you know, thing. So,
yeah. Well, there was, because I was looking through which episodes you were in, and it said you were in the episode, The Bicycle, which was the one of the later episodes in season one. And I was going through and kind of scrolling through the episode, and I'm like, where is he? So I couldn't see you anywhere in it. So whether it was something, an error in the credit, this was just IMDb, or whether you did a scene that then didn't end up was part of something that didn't end up in the final episode. Because there's a couple of episodes that I've had people say, oh, why weren't you in such and such an episode? And I'm like, there was only one episode in 9 years that I didn't have, that I wasn't in.
Yeah.
So it's like, and I went back and I looked through this one episode and I'm like, where am I? I'm like, I know that wasn't an episode that I wasn't in. So again, I think, well, was it a scene that was cut?
Yeah. Well, they dropped me and put me on the floor and that's where it ended.
Yeah. Yeah.
So yeah, that's kind of, in fact, I did the same thing and I actually put a notation next to that I wasn't in the bicycle. Huh. And like, you know, I it's weird because you go back and, you know, obviously it's been a long time and my memory is not what it used to be, but there's things in there that I go, wait a minute, I should have, no, I'm not there. You know, it's things that I should have or thought I was in. And then again, like you said, must have been cut. So hard to know where they get some of their information, you know, whether it was on the dailies or whatever. Yeah. Or, you know,
yeah. I came across one because Sally Boyden, who did one of our Christmas 2-hour ones, the Children's Carol, and she was quite a star in Australia, little singer performer, and it was one of the first things she did when she came to the States, and so she did this two-part episode, and I did a segment like this with her, and we were chatting and stuff, and then I was looking at her IMDb. And it said she was in The Homecoming, but uncredited. And I'm like, she wasn't in The Homecoming. So, and I know sometimes actors, to try and pad their resume, will, I think, add themselves to things on IMDb. But Sally isn't someone who would have done that. So I just think sometimes there's errors in things.
Well, and like, someone looked me up on IMDb and said, oh, Dave, you know, you did this and that and this and that. And it's like, well, yeah, well, what about this? What about that? What about, you know, so there's several things in there. And then I noticed also that you go to some of the credits or whatever, you look on the Waltons and it doesn't have me as GW. It's got me from Nanny and the Professor. And it's like, that's the picture you have. So it'll say like, update your picture, update, you know, any comments that you have. And it's like, forget it.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah. It's like, I can't believe you didn't, but surprisingly enough, I have a number of pictures that, you know, of course, when we go to these events and stuff, these autograph signing events, I've got a lot of pictures. And I know like David Harper says, well, I have hardly any. And it's like, no, Dave, you've got a bunch. And your dad was a photographer. And I know you've got a lot more than you're sharing with people. But just kind of interesting that I have so many pictures of myself in the Waltons. It's just amazing to me that there was that many photographs and stuff. I know I've got one shaking Will Gear's hand, and I've got my army uniform on. Huh. Well, the picture I have is not quite the same angle as the camera.
Huh.
So whoever did that photograph did not take it from the camera view, like some people will copy off, you know, the screen, what they'll see.
Capture, yeah.
Yeah. And I've got the resolution for that particular copy is like, somehow I got an original that somebody, you know, off screen or, you know, off camera was taking pictures, and I got a copy of that. So there's so many things going on that people don't see behind the camera and things like that. I know I was on Bonanza and I was involved in a fight scene and the fight scene kind of went a little wry. It turned into a real fight scene. And one of the people was supposed to be flipped over. And as he flipped over, he's supposed to keep his feet together, but he, you know, widened his legs up and the heel of his boot hit me over the right eye.
Wow.
I am having 6 stitches.
Wow.
And, the director thought, oh, fantastic. You guys are doing so great. Well, yeah, it's a real fight scene. And, you know, and then it's like off stage, left, off stage, off stage. And the director's screaming it, you know, get off stage, stop the fight, so on, as we had rehearsed. And, you know, so I ran off. But then I turned around, like blood's coming down my face. And I walked up to him and I said, excuse me, I think I need to go to the hospital. And everybody starts freaking out and crying. And well, for me, the comical part was, I mean, it hurt like the dickens, but the comical part was typically, you know, in scenes and so on, they'll film the back end of the script or all the scripts that take care, you know, in the kitchen, all the kitchen scenes, and then all the hallway scenes and so on. Well, in this particular situation, the fight scene was after the scene that actually caused the fight scene. So there I was with six stitches over my eye swollen and everything. And they're going like, well, how can we film him? Well, as you probably know, in the very beginning, I had longer hair like on the Waltons, and they draped it over my eye so you couldn't see my eye and went ahead and filmed.
Wow.
But even then, like we were in a schoolhouse and the teacher, you know, they used to use a rulers to smack kids or whatever. I had my hand on the side of the chair and the teacher got mad at me and smacked, well, he was supposed to smack the chair. And after the fifth take, because the director kept saying, move your hand a little closer, move your hand a little closer. Finally, on the fifth take, he hit my hand.
Ooh.
And of course, I jumped as I was supposed to. And the director, oh, perfect, perfect. Yeah, perfect for you, buddy. Thanks. This is one dangerous show. So I'm sure there was a lot of acting. Bonanza was full of so many, you know, things with horses and falling down and stuff like that. I'm sure that happened a lot. So it wasn't unusual to them. But for me, it was like, serious? You really having to beat me up here?
Yeah, I do get asked a lot about things on our show. We didn't have a lot of action stuff, but there, you know, there was stuff that I get asked about. Like we used to ride around in the back of that truck all the time, just sitting up on the edge of the back of that truck, going down the dirt roads, or yeah, you know, there was all kinds of, we ran around barefoot for the first, I don't know how many seasons, until someone stepped on something and they went, put shoes on those kids, you know.
Yeah.
Well, but there wasn't safety stuff. The mill stuff, you know, that was a blade, yep, that was running, and those boys were, and Ralph and Will were running, you know, I mean, fake wood, but, you know, running things through that live blade.
I saw one scene, and it was Will, and he was up in the back of the truck. And I went, surprising they put Will in the back of the truck. I mean, that's just was my instant thought. And sure enough, when the truck started out, he jerked and, you know, you could see he grabbed something to secure himself. But I'm thinking, oh, my gosh, that's an accident waiting to happen. That is.
Yeah. Well, if we were all there, they had to put him in the back because Michael, yep, and Ellen would be in the front of the truck with Ralph.
Right.
The rest of us would be in the back. But, you know, we had to keep track of Cammy so she didn't go pitching out, you know, when she weighed 5 pounds, you know.
Well, and you think about, you know, a wood mill, you know, here you have the saw going and you hear about all the horrific things that can happen with that type of situation. And I'm thinking, golly, it's so great that somebody didn't lose a finger or something during all that.
Yeah, you know, I don't think there were any sawmill accidents. I mean, there was one where John Boy was supposed to get hit with the belt, but that was, you know, a staged thing. I guess Cammy fell out of the treehouse one time, you know, for real.
Yeah.
So, yeah, you know, I don't remember ever getting hurt, but, you know, I think there were odds and ends of things. I don't think anything that ever sent anybody to the hospital, really, you know,
that I
remember. Doesn't mean it didn't happen and I just wasn't there or don't remember.
Well, there was one script I know where we were at a fair and we were chasing a hog.
The pig. Yeah. The greased pig.
Yeah, the great big
end. Surprise, yeah.
I remember it, but I didn't remember it. Well, when I went back and reviewed that particular scene at the very end, I was the one that put the rope on the grease hog's neck. And it's like, whoa, I forgot about that. That's right. I was right there in the middle of things. And, you know, with so many people around and rustling and stuff like that, another potential. But nobody got hurt. Everything was great. And, it was very, very surprising. And I had, tell you the truth, I had forgotten about that. So it's like, oh, it, it is fun going back and seeing that stuff because it brings back memories.
I want to thank David for joining me for part one of our conversation. I will be back with more of my conversation with David, more behind the scenes of the Waltons, more Ask Judy, and who knows what else. Thanks for watching.